Hi everyone, Lee Honish. This came up this week and I don't know if I recorded it or not. And as you're doing stuff this weekend, right? You're working on you this weekend, hopefully open houses or things like that. We have a bunch of EXP agents and we're sort of in the position of being motivational brokers and everything else. And it's the first time actually managing my own agents as well. I said this on Friday, I've said it on the coaching group during the week, and I thought I'd reiterate it for the entire coaching catalog. Remember that you're the product, right? I know I do a lot of motivational stuff and a lot of mindset, and I think that's really important because you are dealing with, we work distressed properties. So these are homeowners that are in a very stressful situation. But what I think is really most important is that you are presenting the product correctly. You yourself are the product, right? You are the gimmick, as they say. So it's important for you to completely understand that this weekend as you're going out. Don't think of yourself in the third person. Think of yourself as a benefit to those you serve. So from a marketing standpoint, from a media standpoint of the product that you physically put out there on social media or in marketing or anything that we teach you, you're the value, right? I will say this, it's really hard for people to realize that they have value, especially when you don't think you know completely what you're working on, right? It's kind of scary on some level. But the reason I bring all that up for you, I'll just speak from my own personal experience, which is what I try to do with everything. I can tell you, for as much as I know about distressed properties, and most of you know my story and how I've gotten myself together over the last year and made radical life changes. I wouldn't say that I'm a vegan on top of it all, but certainly a keto person. I look on the outside how I feel on the inside. But one of the most shocking things wasn't until I was on the road recently with Derek. We were speaking and coming out of, I don't know, Texas. And I was talking to him, and I've said it before, I'll say it again. I was talking to my therapist on the phone, and it dawned on me that I believed in the value that I have. It's not that I don't think that I know everything fundamentally there is about distressed property, distressed marketing, asset management, anything really. My niche is this pre-foreclosure group, right? It is completely my niche. It's been my niche for 30, almost 40 years. And over the last 14 years, working specifically with meeting those people, engaging them and getting listings out of them. That is my niche. That is what I have done. Even when I try to get away from it, it draws me back in. It's just like the Godfather Part 3. Every time I try to get out, it drags me back in. Okay. I didn't realize that it had physical value to those that I help, that I that invest in me, that I do the marketing for. I'm humbled and grateful for every single one of you that's on my list or invested in a product or bought a squeeze page or whatever and allowed for the nuances of my eccentric behaviors or public relationships that go up in flame. I mean, the person I was in the past is completely ridiculous, completely. And the reason I tell you all of that, put all your personal drama aside. Start today being the value that I know you are. You watch these videos, you believe in your worth as a real estate professional, or even if you're an investor, you believe in yourself, okay? I was always looking for validation in others to believe in me or to love me or whatever it is. That mindset limited me and made me do things quite publicly, I mean, to be perfectly honest, that I'm embarrassed by, right? But I can't look at that situation. The minute I fundamentally understood that I believed in my value, that I loved myself, and I know it all seems very hokey and I try not to roll my eyes while shooting this video and telling you guys all of this. You have value. You have a skill that I am barely working on, okay? Which is you want to meet with people. You want to connect with people. None of you are at the expert level of me, excluding a couple of you, right? Where you can talk about this from A to Z the way I do. I work a very specific group of people. I always have. It's where I started. It's apparently where I'm going to end in this industry. And I'm grateful. It benefits a bunch of families and people just like you, but it also helps, you know, it's helped millions at this point. And I am humbled by it, and I completely understand it, and I'm happy to share the information with you. So my point to all this is, be that gimmick, right? Whatever your strength is, bring it out. If you're good at connecting with people and listening to them, that's it. You don't have to be an expert. When you get to the point of needing an expert, then you bring me in, okay? You bring Derek in, you bring Gina in. I can get you people for just about every expert niche of this process, right? Because there are people that are way smarter about some of these things than me. I do not think I am the end all be all. I know for many of you who've known me previously that I've kind of adopted that attitude, but that's not accurate. So take what you value the most right now, and that's how you shoot your videos. That's the projection of what you put out there. I'm not embarrassed by anything I've said on this video. I'm not embarrassed for anybody to see this video that I'm putting out there. And that's the way you should feel. I'm not breaking eye contact. I'm not rolling my eyes at myself. I'm not looking away, right? When you're telling someone, I really want to help you, and you're looking off like that, those things project, right? You've got to believe it. And don't put yourself in their shoes. Why would anybody believe me? Why would I have that mindset? I say this to friends and people I care about all the time. Whose voice is that in your head that's making you feel that way? Because you got to stop it, right? That's not how people perceive you. That's how you perceive you. So you really need to stop. I would really recommend trying to understand that 95% of your behaviors are based on subconscious behaviors. One of the hardest things that I've had to do in my life is being in control of my subconscious and stop listening to the voice of my father who dragged me into this industry and listening to others who've told me that I'm not good enough. In one case, in a relationship, you're not as big a deal as you think you are. I am a big deal. I've helped a million people, okay? I am a huge deal, okay? And I have a lot of worth behind that. And I wanna share that with this market, right? That's what I bring, and that's what this video is about. So when you're creating a 3-minute video to try to generate for someone, or you're putting up a blog post, which nobody does anymore or writes anything, even I rolled my eyes at that one and looked away. Nobody does blog posts, but I would like to believe that those are still a thing. A podcast, any kind of content. You're the gimmick. Make me care about the one thing you've got that you bring to the table, right? I, on any given day, feel it very ironic that the thing that I'm trying to bring to the table is my value and my vulnerability of understanding the situation, right? Because previously I just didn't care. I didn't care about their situation. I didn't care about any of that. It was, I guess, just being awesome. And I don't think being awesome is a gimmick. I was also a banker. And I was also literally the best marketer on distressed properties out there, and ultimately becoming the best marketer for real estate professionals, period, and understanding it, right? I made it a fundamental thing about me to understand it, but I didn't place my vulnerability or who I am. I didn't want you to know anything about me, because if you knew the truth about me, you wouldn't want to be around me, right? Whose voice is that in my head, right? What X is that in my head? What person is that in my head? Right now, as you're saying this, and someone is saying you're stupid in your head. Just had this talk this morning with my CFO, love her to death, and she's the best CFO on the planet, and she did something. She goes, I'm stupid. I said, no, you're not stupid. Whose voice is that in your head? And tell it to stop, okay? I don't think that about any of you. I think you genuinely want to go out and help people, and I hope that this sort of Saturday motivational to all of you. Go shoot a video. Go do an open house. I challenged my EXP group to go out. It's a 5-person challenge. We have a bet going, and I'll challenge all of you on my email list for Saturday. Okay, go out and talk to 5 people about distressed properties. Do an icebreaker. Do any of the stuff Derek teaches on any of those calls, or just go to a farmer's market. And I challenge my group to talk to 5 people and let them know what you do for a living. And what you do for a living is I work distressed properties, right? I work with people with missed payments. It's a real simple conversation. You're going in, you want to find out what someone does for a living, just start a conversation, however you're comfortable doing it. Once you do that, they're going to, by the law of reciprocation, ask what you do. It's very common, right? I work with people who miss payments. And I was betting my agents, my EXP agents, that if they talk to five people, they will get one, what I would call a warm lead. Just five. Just talk to five people. I think the numbers are so great that none of you realize how great the numbers are. And if you want to make sure, right, here's exactly the framing on it. And for my EXP agents that are watching this, bets on, right? You're trying to win a day with me, basically doing your marketing. So here's how the bet lays out. I want you to go out, farmer's market. I'm here in Las Vegas, go walk downtown. Whatever it is that you want to do in your personal market where you know people are going to be congregating. I don't know if last night I went to a really great dive bar to go watch a cover band. I don't know if that's the venue for it, but pretty much everywhere else I've been, and I brought up this conversation because I was doing it myself yesterday while I was out and about on foot here in Vegas. Everywhere I've started that conversation, there has been someone to tell me a story. Now, I have no need to follow up. I'm not looking for leads, but I'm going to give you sort of the flow chart for it, for you to go out and, you know, get yourself a warm lead. And what you'll understand from the point of this exercise, same thing I'm teaching my EXP agents, right? By being in the zone, by doing these things, you'll see that it's one, really happening around you, which creates more value. You believe in the education that's behind you. Number two, you will find people who will need your assistance, right? At the end of the day, the goal here is to find people that want to do loan mods, forbearance agreements, refinance, or sell their house. I mean, that's what you're looking for. I mean, well, just what's in it for you? That's what's in it for you. But again, 85% of what we do is for free. It's the 15% that pay us, right? Okay. So do an icebreaker. I don't know what yours is. For me, it's herky jerky and awful. I'm still working on my people skills. Derek has worked tirelessly to make it so that I can interact with humans so it's not awkward. Number two, once you've done that, I just do it by either having a computer. I'll explain my methodology. Like, I was at Giordano's the other day eating the center out of a pizza. Eating the center out of a pizza was the icebreaker. Oh my gosh, you eat the center out of a pizza. You don't like the crust? I said, I love the crust. I eat keto for my work. Really, what do? I teach people how to work with homeowners who have missed payments, you know, that have done loan mods because of COVID. There it is. Got it out there. That's what I do. Okay. That led to, oh my gosh, I know someone who did a forbearance agreement. I said, wow, I feel really bad. Did they know it's going to affect their credit? No, I don't think they had any idea. Now, I could have pushed that forward another step, but I didn't. But that's where you want to go in the warm lead, right? Can you get a hold of them? Would it be okay? Because it's kind of what I do. I would love to talk to them and let them know what their options are. And as long as they have good education, that's the goal of our company, right? So they understand all their alternatives and what's happening to them. It helps us with a mission. That always gets me to, what's your mission? We're trying to help 1 million homeowners. We believe that there's somewhere between 3 to 5 million people who are going to be facing eviction, who are going to have really negative impacts on their credit, and we're just trying to educate that market. That's it. I'm not doing crazy things at Costco to accost people and tell them my story, and, you know, I'm not shaking the tree. I'm not even really technically engaging anybody. It's my actions of what I do. And I project who I am. And to be honest, who I am today brings wonderful things into my life, wonderful conversations, wonderful people, and they are all of the same like mindset. I get all asked all the time, aren't you afraid things in your past are sort of gonna pop out and people are gonna wanna talk to you? I said, no, I attract people just like me. I had conversations yesterday with a Lyft driver. He was a guy looking for answers who's been meditating and like doing all the stuff that I'm doing. I had a great conversation with somebody I extraordinarily respect in this industry yesterday. And it was another one of those conversations of, I don't know why I'm talking to you. And I said, are you meditating? Are you doing self-affirmations? And the conversation And of course, the answer was yes. How did you know? I said, that's the only people I attract. I attract like. The law of the universe is true. The reason you're not getting deals, I know, and you're rolling your eyes at me. Okay, some of you are. Stop it. It's that you got to do it. You got to believe that you're attracting whatever you are. So if you're not getting good leads and things aren't going your way and everything's kind of crappy, hey, surprise, you're attracting it. Okay, so project a message of value and of greatness. And you got a solid weekend. So I'm going to challenge the whole email list. I'm not going to give you the same bet they do because I bet everyone, if you talk to five people and you don't get a warm lead, I'm going to do your marketing for the weekend. I'm not doing that for you on my regular email list. I'm doing this because if you go out and do five, you know, talk to five people, most of you won't do it. You're rolling your eyes at me right now. Just tell me how to put the tags up, Lee, and we'll go do that. And, you know, we'll just muddle through it. It's not how this works. You got to believe in your value. Stop overanalyzing. Stop asking what if. Go bring yourself out. Remember, you're the gimmick. You're the product. That is the biggest thing to bring forward when you're doing video marketing, when you're doing monster marketing, when you're doing face-to-face. These are things you fundamentally have to understand. Got it? Go out and kill it this weekend. Be amazing. I do appreciate all of you, as does my team. I appreciate all of you. And for those that are showing up on Monday, fantastic. If you didn't get a seat for Monday and you are in the Vegas or LA area and you can be there, we added an extra hour. Go to homeadvocateslive.com. Yes, I know the seats are expensive. You should have invested sooner. I didn't know I was going to add an extra hour. I didn't know I was going to have special guests. This has turned into probably one of the hottest events for anybody working in the distressed field. If I had time, I'd probably market the entire company, country, which tells me that there are people that are like-minded. We are not alone. And I'll also say this, there are going to be a lot of people who think you're crazy. My advice, excuse my French, because I'm definitely recording this, fuck them. You believe in what you want to believe. That's it. Believe in you. Believe in the market you want to believe in. And don't take anything personally for agreements. Don't make assumptions about other people. Let them be them. Cool. I get hate mail every day that I'm just trying to rile up audiences and I'm trying to scare people. That's not accurate. I'm literally running around like Paul Revere trying to explain that these things are going to happen. And I've had it confirmed for me repeatedly by people in the industry and by the news and the lack of news. So, there you go. There's your Saturday motivational. Go out and talk to some distressed homeowners. Talk to five people and see if you can't find somebody who will tell you a forbearance story. There's my challenge to you. I'd love to hear about it on Wednesday. Bring your stories. We'll talk about it on Wednesday. And have an awesome weekend.